Besides regulatory action by BCA, it's also important for town councillors as lift owners to take responsibility and to carry out proactive maintenance and cyclical replacement of lifts. For example, town councillors can analyse the lift fault data from the telemonitoring system and the records of residents' feedback to identify lifts in the estate which may require more attention. And then town councillors should also have qualified personnel within their management teams who can supervise the contractors and work with them to put in place an effective maintenance regime. A more comprehensive lift maintenance and replacement program will cost more. For example, with more rigorous checks over time, town councillors are likely to draw more on their sinking funds to replace worn-out lift parts or to carry out a complete replacement of older lifts. So town councillors must project and plan ahead and ensure sufficient savings for long-term financial sustainability. And that's why MND intends to require all town councils to set aside a higher proportion of their SNCC collections into their sinking funds and to ring fence a part of the sinking fund specifically for lift replacement.
I'd just like to ask the Minister specifically with regard to lifts which are above 20 years of age, which the Minister has acknowledged tend to have more maintenance-related issues. I think the point of balance for a town council would be to enhance contracts and by doing so require regular maintenance, and that would mean essentially increasing routine expenditure for the town council. Offset against making a decision to replace the lift or upgrade the lift earlier. So that would, of course, entail the use of sinking funds. So that's the real issue for many town councils, I believe. And in that light, with regard to the safety enhancements that the Minister has spoken about that HDB are looking at, and because they may cost a large sum of money, does the Minister have any estimate of when HDB will come to that decision? Because town councils will have to start determining how to project their finances going forward.
Madam, I think that's a fair question because, and I recognise the point that town councils need the information early to plan ahead, right? And so we are doing the study even right now, and we will be informing town councils in due course what we intend to do for the safety enhancements and what vintage of lifts. Obviously, it would not make sense for us to spend a lot of money on safety enhancements on the lift that is already going to be due for replacement next year, because the better thing to do, as the member has, Mr. Singh has suggested, is for the town councils to replace these very old lifts. So these safety enhancements would be done, as I mentioned in my answer earlier, for lifts that are not due for replacement soon. Exactly what age we will have to study. And this is not going to be done, this will take time to implement as well, because we're talking about a huge stock of existing lifts which we'll have to do progressively over a few years. But I know the town councils need the data and the information to plan, and we will strive to provide this information as soon as possible.